What's up, friends and family? Mr. Flip Flop, how I do? First off, let's put all this nonsense to rest. The internet is undefeated. You guys are something else with your rumors. There is no beef, no drama, no nothing. Watch my videos, I'm talking about everybody. I'm not talking about no one, two, three people specific. You free to follow and listen to whoever you want. I'm just here to be helpful. And first off, I'm in paradise. What am I arguing anybody for? I got a bad temper, so I'm not trying to argue with nobody. All right, so there is no beef. You guys can cut out the rumors and the speculations. There is no beef, especially not with me. So we're cool, all right? So enough of that drama talk. I found it funny, real talk. But there is no beef about anything. Mr. Flip Flop, I appreciate all those that paved the way for YouTube. You know, I didn't want to do YouTube, but I'm glad I did because I'm here to help. I'm just being helpful, giving real advice, real information. And like I said, you have a choice to click on it, just block me, decide who you want to watch, decide who you want to listen to. Totally your choice. But I appreciate you being here with me. So we're going to talk about living abroad and why. Okay, so if you remember my story, I had my own company, you know, a personal trainer. And it was pretty good. But I traveled a lot, you know. Before I moved here, I made the move. I was here every 2 weeks. Yes, I was visiting Dominican Republic just about every 2 weeks. I had a lot of stamps on my passport. Because here, this was my getaway. You know, I worked all the time, nonstop. I had a nice-ass crib, you know, my cars. Everything was kind of nice, you know. I had a nice lifestyle. But you wouldn't, if I told you how I lived, you would never know because I never had company. I never had time, you know. So one day one of my trainers was like, you know, trying to ask me to go out and hang out for drinks. And I said, no, I've got stuff to do. And they were like, this is the exact question they asked me. Do you live to work or work to live? And I couldn't answer that. I just know I enjoyed working. I'll tell you about that later. I'm a grinder, you know, I bust my butt no matter what I do. I told you guys, I grew up in not the greatest situation, so I always said I'm gonna just work hard. You know, I was given a great work ethic by my peoples, and I always said I'm gonna just work harder than everybody else. That's what I do. So I started coming, you know, every 2 weeks, like I told you. Then I stayed a month one time. I actually got sick 2 weeks prior, so I decided to stay the entire month. I had issues with my stomach. Then it led to 2 months. Then it led to, I think, 6 months, then 9 months. I'm sorry, I got some things written down, but a lot of stuff's in my head. And then I said, you know what? It's time to make the move. I'm ready to make the move. I felt I adjusted enough, and I was ready to make the move. Small adjustment. I mean, I miss my peoples, but they came to visit me. Halloween, a lot of my people from my neighborhood come down, you know. My sister happened to come down once. My mother came down when my first son down here was born. She came back 2 more times to visit me or whatever. So, you know, my people's come down to visit me, you know. Do I miss the States? The stress, no. The grind, no. But, you know, my people's, yeah. I mean, there's certain things about the States. I'm not going to be rich here, you know, but I'm okay with that because the cost of living is so low. It's okay. Now, because I worked for a corporation prior to start my own company, I actually had a nice amount of income, so I was living above the means of most people. But when I left, I realized, had I not been doing that, I kind of wouldn't have been getting by. You know, I wouldn't be able to have a car or a house or apartments, none of that. I mean, I just wouldn't. My grind actually gave me the money to do the things I was able to do. So the small adjustments. Getting adjusted to not living like a tourist was a big thing. $1,000 can last you a month down here, living here. But $1,000 can't last you a week as a tourist. It's just a different vibe. You're coming down on party vibe, hanging out vibe, drinking, clubbing, whatever the case may be. So the money's different. So when you're living here, you kind of have to remember, I have to have a budget. I have to do things a certain way. You know, you have to find your way. You got to lose the tourist mentality and do things differently. Okay, so that was a big obstacle. But I knew I had to do it, and that's why staying the couple of months at a time, you know, that kind of got me into adapting to, okay, change how we're doing things. Change the way we're going to spend money. You know, I can't do VIP every night anymore. I would love to, but I can't. I can't go out drinking with the fellas every night, you know. You know, just change the way we do things, just so the money makes sense now, you know. I had no real plan. I just wanted to leave the country. And as I said, I depend on me. I believe in me. So, yes, most people will call me stupid. Shoot, maybe later on in life, I would call me stupid. But I've always just got up and moved. I've lived in so many different states because I just wanted to. Funny story, my cousin had an issue with his mother one time, my aunt. And he calls me and he goes, hey, man, I'm going to Atlanta. What's up? I turned around and I said, how long before you pick me up? Within an hour, we're on the road to Atlanta. No plan, no nothing, just went to Atlanta. I lived in South Carolina. I went to visit one time, met two people. I moved to South Carolina. And the two people I met, I never saw them again. You know, I'm that type of person. I feel I'm gonna do something, I go and do it, you know. Sometimes no rhyme or reason, sometimes no grand scheme plan. But, you know, I believe in me. Same thing when I did here. I said, you know what? I believe I can do it. I did it. Now, as far as work, I work my butt off. Those who know, hit me, email me, WhatsApp me. I'm answering. I done had a dude laugh, say, dude, I sent you a message at 5 in the morning. I thought you would hit me back to later. I hit him back 5 minutes later. I'm always working. But the difference here from me grinding here and working so hard here is I'm at the bar talking to people, which that video came from my conversations with the fellas at the bar. I'm in the club. I'm still working, but I'm in the club. I'm at an event or party or something. I'm still working. I'm on the beach. I'm still working. It's just my atmosphere is different. I'm the type of person, I can't sit around and do anything, so there will be no, I don't work. That's cool for some people. I just never been that way. Okay, to get in my work ethic, I watched my grandfather bust his butt forever, since I could remember. And then the Board of Education forced him to retire. You know, he's like, listen, we can't pay you no more. You've reached that age, you know, it's time for you to go. Now, you know, when they say when you retire, if you sit idle, most people die early after retirement. You can look it up. I think 2.5 years after he retired, he died. And that's because his routine was broken. You know, he would get up every day, go to work, work, and come home. That was his routine every single day. Now, every morning I watch that man sit, mow the lawn every single day, cut the hedges every single day. Because he had nothing to do. You know, do the driveway every day. And, you know, I love that, man. Great work ethic, which I definitely got me going. But, you know, he didn't enjoy his life. And then he dies right after he retires. So for me, I was always like, I'm going to do my own thing. And I've always done my own thing. So, you know, I just felt that it was time to move on. And the Dominican Republic became a place. Does it stop here? I can't tell you that. You know, I'm happy where I'm at. I'm happy with Flip Flop, how the business is going. Happy with my situations. I don't get mad. Like, you know, I've gotten mad here and there, certain things. But I try not to, because the reality is I don't want people to see, you know, that side. And also, I'm in paradise. Like, the reality is I had a by myself meeting yesterday. I had to remember, dude, you're in paradise. Some people are jealous. Some people are upset. So what? You know, everybody kept, so many messages, man. I love all you guys. Everybody kept saying, listen, if you ain't got no haters, they ain't doing nothing. I had haters before YouTube. So it's cool. I guess YouTube, I'm going to get more. It is what it is, but I'm going to keep doing my thing. And I'm going to keep hollering at you guys, giving you good information. You know, I've been holding all this information in. And honestly, the videos are coming more because this is kind of my therapy. The same way I just sat at the bar for the past 3 hours, chopping it up. That's my therapy. So these videos, giving you the info and telling you my experiences, is my therapy kind of now. You know, where I didn't want to do the camera thing, now I'm doing it, and this is my therapy. My stress level is down. You know, my biggest thing is the fake people. You know, but you weed them out. You can tell who's fake and who's not. That's not even a question. You know, the wave catchers, as the young people say. I try to keep up with my slang. The wave catchers, you know, people who see you doing something and try to run off of that. It is what it is. The biggest thing is you can come in tomorrow and start what you're doing, and then someone will try to take it. But the common denominator is the person, not always the business. So it is what it is. I spent over 10 years building a name here, doing what I do. I've had various partners who along the way we did great things in this town and other towns. So, you know, what it is. You build good relationships, you network with good people, everything else plays out in itself. So, you know, the stress level's down. My life, to me, is amazing. You know, the money, I'm not going to get rich here. As I said, I'm not going to be rich, but I'm okay, you know. I don't need a lot of money here. So, for me, we just went out had some drinks. Hey, I got the money to pay for drinks. I'm okay. You know, my rent's paid. Everything's good. You know, it's just, I don't plan on getting rich here. It's okay. That's not for me. But the peace of mind is more important to me than money. I've had a lot of money at one point in my life, and I was not happy. So the peace of mind means more to me than money. That's just my reality. A lot of people get mad because, you know, I'm young and I'm doing something different. You know, they always want to see an old geezer doing something. You know, he can't own anything. He can't be that smart, you know, to because he's young and dumb. I mean, I grew up around a lot of, everybody says I got an old soul. I grew up around a lot of old heads. People my age weren't doing what I was doing when I was younger. So my mind is said it's different, you know. So I just carry that experience and just do what I do. You know, everybody, you know from jump if you know me, if you heard about me, if you've talked to me, I'm just different. You know, my mindset is different. Anything about me is different. A lot of people don't like that, you know. But as I said, I give nothing but respect to those that paved the way. Not just YouTube, Instagram, I'm talking about business out here. I've come across some great people. Besides the negative, I've come across great people. I was able to be partners with a great person. I'll leave him nameless, probably there was a name out there. Me and him did some great things for years. So, you know, I always will do, give credit where credit is due, you know. I've seen, now, the thing about living here, even if it's short term, I've seen success stories and I've seen horror stories. You know, some people do good, some people don't. It's not for everybody. You know, if you remember a previous video, I told you, I don't want anybody to quit their job, just run down here. Please, don't do that. But if you plan on just changing your life, you know, getting out of that matrix mindset, as they say, you know, you might want to consider making a plan. I tell everybody, have a plan. Don't just, you know, I had no plan. I won't lie to you, I had no plan. But this is from a almost 40 years of my life, making my own decisions, doing what I wanted to do. You know, I wasn't with the status quo, I wasn't really with the 9-to-5. I've always done my own thing. So my path was always, hey, what do I feel like doing today? How am I going to do things? Cool. Now I have a regimen. Now I have a set schedule on things I like to do. I try to stick to a schedule at least. So that's my path now. But it's my path, but it's always been my path. I do what I want to do when I want to do it. You know, may not always be the right decision for my life, but I go with my gut. I go with how I feel. I go with my heart, you know. Hey, is this good? Yeah, let's do it. Now, later, if it's bad, I'll go, hey, Greg, should have did a better decision. But, hey, we're nothing if we don't take chances, you know? So, I wrote this down because it's something I remember, you know, my grandfather, like I told you guys. But all the drama stuff, I had drama before YouTube, so it's okay. But there is no drama, you know? If you ever met me, I'm cool as hell. I don't like drama. I come from a background full of drama. I don't want none of that stuff. You know, we're in paradise. You know, if you're mad and you're in an island, on an island, excuse me, you have an issue. You know what I'm saying? So I had to really sit down and think about that. There's no reason to be mad at anybody or anything, no matter what's said, no matter what someone thinks is said. The reality is we're in paradise and we got to enjoy it. So that was my journey. That's the reason why I'm here. So I'm going to actually do a couple series. My series are all going. This is just, like I said, this is therapy for me, so it's getting out. But, you know, my why was because I wanted a change of scenery. I wanted something different. And because I couldn't figure out, was I working to live or living to work? I couldn't figure it out. So I said, it's time for a change of scene. I work just as hard, if not more, in Dominican Republic for way less money. But the atmosphere is different. The stress level is lower. Everything's different here for me. Okay, so, you know, that's my why as far as living abroad. You have to figure out your why. Why do you want to leave? Why? What are you going to do? What is your situation? Do you have retirement? Do you have a pension? Do you want to start a business? Do you have a plan? So you have to figure out your why. And once you figure out your why, you can make that move, whether it be Dominican Republic, Colombia. I got a lot of friends that live in Colombia. Wherever you decide to go to live abroad. But the first question you got to ask yourself, and that's the first part to all of this, is why? My why is because I needed to change the scenery. I wanted to do something different. You need to figure out what your why is so you can make the plan and make the move. Okay, so I appreciate you guys. Hit the like, subscribe, hit the notification. Make sure you see when my videos are coming up. And appreciate the support. Keep sending me the emails. I answer all your questions. And Mr. Flip Flop, and I'm out.